Here is the middle press conference Kashmiri Pandit Diaspora, global Kashmiri Pandit Diaspora. We are not an organization. We are not an organization, we are not a party. This is a global initiative of Kashmiri Pandits. And it represents Kashmiri Pandits all over the world who have been displaced from Kashmir, who have been thrown into exile. And we have people in the United States, America, Britain, Europe, Finland, New Zealand, Australia, and all the states of India. Now our main aim is for the world to recognize that Kashmiri Pandits are the real victims of genocide and ethnic cleansing. If you recall 19th January of 30 years back, since 30 years we are in exile. You recall the jihadi slogans from loudspeakers, which were put on the mosques and housetops, asking Kashmiri Pandits to leave and leave their women behind. You recall the mass processions of frenzied people giving the same slogans that we want Pakistan without Kashmiri Pandits for the dear world. Recall the systematic killings which took place across the valley of Kashmir, irrespective of gender, age, and irrespective of status of people. They started killing Kashmiri Pandits one by one and driving them out of the villages, threatening them, torturing them, abducting them, even raping women and killing them, leaving them by the side of the roads and the fields, not allowing their people even to take the dead bodies away, even to mourn for them. Some dead bodies had to be taken and brought to Jammu for the cremation. Gentlemen and ladies, genocide means intention to kill, to decimate, to finish off a community, to murder a community. All these things happen on that day, and the intent to throw the community away, exculpate it from its roots. You all know we are an ethno-religious community. We are a minority in Kashmir, and ever since independence, we have been subject to deprivation, human rights violation. So this systematic and slow and subtle exculpation was going on. Exclusion of our community from the main social stream was going on. But then the acne, the frenzy of Azadi, the jihad, which took over and accelerated this process of ethnic cleansing. Gentlemen, nobody till date has acknowledged that Kashmiri Pandits are the victims of ethnic cleansing and genocide. We are taking it to a higher scale. We have been fighting in India and also on international bodies. The best we could get so far by the National Human Rights Commission was that yes, your status, your condition is something akin to genocide. Basically, we want to prove to the world that it was genocide and nothing short of genocide. You would all know that we went to the Supreme Court. We are at this time, we are taking it up on an international scale. That's why we are having this global Kashmiri Pandits. That means we have the support of each and every Kashmiri Pandit who has been thrown out, who has now been fend for their lives, to get shelter, to get space. They have been moving on. Basically, we have been migrating like nomads from one state to another, from one country to another. That's why the whole diaspora is with us. Basically, GKPD, Kashmiri Pandit Global Diaspora, is a community, collective community consciousness of our identity. This has given us a platform to for unity of action, unity of purpose, and the whole world is with us. Local Kashmiri Pandit organizations are behind us. The common man is behind us. What we are doing now is we are documenting all the facts and figures of the crimes that have been perpetrated against us. We are making it absolutely world class. We are taking the best help of professionals, lawyers, historians, who will trace our history right from 5,000 years in the state of Kashmir. And we are going to also go to the European bodies, other national human rights organizations of other countries. We are taking our help of certain other NGOs. We have a Netherlands-based NGO, which is called Global Human Rights Defense, with which we are this time in collaboration. They have promised to help us, and they will give us a peer review of the data that we are going to submit. That data will show all the killings, systematic killings, the people who were killed, where they were killed, who they were, which village they were, what was their status. We are going to show them what has happened to our properties that we left behind, in spite of the fact that there is a bill in our state legislature of the prevention and protection of temple property, prevention and protection of what so-called migrant property. We are going to collect, we have already collected, the thousands, hundreds of our temples and shrines which have been encroached upon, annexed. Some of them have been totally destroyed. Our most precious symbols of our culture and religion have been desecrated. Our temple gods have been insulted, and we are going to come with proof. You all know that when Bamiyan Buddhas were blasted by the people in Afghanistan, Taliban, the whole world body rose in one to despise this act. But nobody probably knows that some of our temples and shrines which have been encroached upon, annexed, and which have been appropriated, they are even more ancient than the Taliban. We are going to show that there is a cultural genocide, that there is a, besides the physical genocide, we have suffered cultural genocide, we have suffered religious genocide. That's our main aim.
Now, what is your demand from government?
Demand, we are not demanding anything from government in India. We want the government of India to recognize that we are internal refugees. Gentlemen, you might be knowing recently there has been a ruling in United Nations. Now they say that internal displaced people are also internal refugees. First, we want this migrant label, which is despicable. We just hate that label. This is an insult to our bruised sensibility. We want government of India to recognize that we are not just internally displaced, we are internal refugees, as per the definition of the United Nations. That's one. Because that will give us a different entity, that identity, and that will give us some different benefits as a community. We want to go to the international bodies to recognize, yes, genocide took place of this ethnic minority, religious minority, and once that recognition comes, that changes the whole configuration of Kashmir. We want the world also to know that in any solution of Kashmiri, whenever you call Kashmiri for a dialogue, whoever they may be, the first people to be called are not the people who raise the guns, who are separatists, who are in collusion with external countries, who are in collusion, who are backed and financed by Pakistan and other terrorist states, who are backed by the funds from Islamic countries. They are not to be called for a consultation. It is the Kashmiri Pandits who are the real victims of jihad, who are the victims of Islamic terrorism and fascism. They are the real stakeholders of Kashmir. That's another thing we are wanting.
Global Kashmiri Pandit Diaspora एक identity है, एक party organization नहीं है। ये सारे कश्मीरी जो हैं, जो स्थापित हैं, जो निकाले गए हैं, जो अभी भी nomads की तरह एक city से दूसरी city को जाते हैं for shelter and for space for just life, and they have moved on to different countries, and now we have a huge global diaspora, and their heart and soul is Kashmir. तो वो सारे लोग कश्मीर जाना चाहते हैं, और उससे पहले हम सारी दुनिया को ये मनवाना चाहते हैं कि कश्मीरी पंडित फ्रंटलाइन विक्टिम्स हैं ऑफ जेनोसाइड एंड एथनिक क्लीनिंग. we had people who threw us out, हमें बाहर निकाला, उन्होंने torture, terror, murder and rape कर लिया, threatenings की, अखबारों में notice दिए कि 24 घंटे, 48 घंटे में कश्मीर निकलो नहीं तो you face death और अपनी औरतों को पीछे रखो, आप बाहर जाओ और औरतों को पीछे छोड़ो। तो ये सारा जो intention to dismay our community, हमारी community को बाहर निकालना है, वो उन्होंने तकरीबन अचीव किया है और अभी तक कोई international body, कोई national body ने ये acknowledge नहीं किया है कि हम victims हैं genocide and ethnic cleansing के। इस समय हम सारे इकट्ठे मिले हैं, सारे organisation, सारे लोग, एक से ऊपर से नीचे तक जितने भी लोग हैं कश्मीरी पंडित, वो इसमें जुड़े हैं। ये एक इनिशिएटिव है, ये एक आइडेंटिटी है, ये अब हमारी कलेक्टिव कम्युनिटी कॉन्शियसनेस है और हम ये कॉन्शियसनेस है कि हम शिकार हैं, विक्टिम्स हैं एथनिक क्लीनिंग और जेनोसाइड के। हम यूनाइटेड नेशन जा रहे हैं उनको कहने के लिए कि ये आप रिकॉग्नाइज करो। हम अपनी नेशन से भी दोबारा रिक्वेस्ट करेंगे कि यू एक्सेप्ट द फैक्ट हम माइग्रेंट नहीं हैं, हम निकाले गए हैं और हम इंटरनल रिफ्यूजीज हैं। अकॉर्डिंग टू यूएन डेफिनेशन वी आर इंटरनल रिफ्यूजीज एंड वी डिजर्व दैट ट्रीटमेंट। वी डोंट डिजर्व टू बी ट्रीटेड एज डॉग्स एंड पैरियर्स, वी डोंट डिजर्व टू बी ट्रीटेड टू बी पिटी। वी आर हियर टू आस्क फॉर आवर राइट्स एंड दैट्स व्हाट वी होप वी विल गेट।
थैंक यू। सर, आज की जो प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस थी, इसका क्या मकसद क्या था?
इसका मकसद मैंने बोल दिया कि हम सारे दुनिया को उजागर करना चाहते हैं कि कश्मीरी पंडित स्थापित जो हैं वो जो सारी सारे देश में फैले हैं अपने जॉब्स के लिए, अपनी सिक्योरिटी के लिए और जो बाकी विदेशों में फैले हैं, उन्होंने एक बनाई एक अम्ब्रेला, ये ऑर्गेनाइजेशन नहीं है, पार्टी नहीं है, एक मूवमेंट है, एक इनिशिएटिव है कि वर्ल्ड बॉडीज और नेशनल बॉडीज रिकॉग्नाइज करें कि हम एथनिक क्लीनिंग और जेनोसाइड के शिकार हैं, कि हमें इंटेंशनली कश्मीर से भगाया गया, डिसिमिनेट कराया गया, हमारे जो रिलीजियस इंस्टीट्यूशन हैं वो अंडर असॉल्ट हैं, हमारी आइडेंटिटी अंडर असॉल्ट है, हमारे जो लेफ्ट ओवर प्रॉपर्टीज़ हैं वो उन्होंने सब हड़प लिए हैं, हमारे जो मंदिरों में जो उनकी दुर्दशा हुई है, जो हमारे गॉड्स को डिसिपेट किया गया है, जो इतने एंशेंट हैं कि गुआम्यान बुद्धा से भी एंशेंट है, उनको ख़त्म कर दिया है सिस्टमेटिकली। कश्मीर में सारे नॉन मुस्लिम जो चिन्ह हैं, नॉन मुस्लिम आइडेंटिटीज़ हैं, चाहे वो श्राइन हो, चाहे वो जगहें हो, चाहे जगहों के नाम हो, और खैर कश्मीरी उनको बाहर निकाला है, वो ख़त्म कर दिया गया है। इस समय अगर मैं बोल रहा हूँ, कश्मीर तकरीबन इस्लामिक हुआ है, वहाँ 7000 मस्जिदें बनी हैं और 7000 टेम्पल्स ख़त्म हो गए। तो ये देखना है कि ये हो क्या, जो विक्टिम्स हैं, जो इसके शिकार हैं, वो कहाँ हैं, वो सड़ रहे हैं, वो मर रहे हैं, उनके नंबर्स डिमिनिश हो रहे हैं, हमारी पॉपुलेशन श्रिंक हो रही है, ए डिस्टिंक्ट एथनो रिलीजियस कम्युनिटी इज ग्रेजुअली श्रिंकिंग। इस वक्त वर्ल्ड को फिक्र है कि वहाँ पर जो हांगलूज हैं, जो रेयर स्पीशीज ऑफ बर्ड्स हैं, जो रेयर स्पीशीज ऑफ एनिमल्स हैं, उनके लिए पता नहीं दुनिया का क्या क्या कर रही है, कितने ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बना रही है, कितने फंड्स कलेक्ट कर रही है और एक ह्यूमन स्पीशीज ख़त्म हो रही है, उस पर किसी को फिक्र नहीं है। वो हम ये उजागर करना चाहते हैं कि हम लोग हैं, इससे पहले कि हमारा सारे ये आइडेंटिटी ख़त्म हो जाए, एक जिसकी 5000 ईयर ओल्ड एंशिएंट हिस्ट्री है, जिन्होंने सारे इंडिया को हिंदू रिलीजन के ओरिजिनल शैविक का फिलॉसफी, शैविक फिलॉसफी इज द ग्रेटेस्ट फिलॉसफी ऑफ इंक्लूजन ऑफ कलेक्टिव वर्ल्ड ह्यूमैनिटी, वो दिया है, वी आर फिनिशिंग दैट। ये वर्ल्ड कहाँ जाए अगर ऐसी कम्युनिटी को जो पीसफुल कम्युनिटी है उनको आप फेंकोगे बाहर जाट के, और कोई कोई
यहाँ। आपके अभी नेक्स्ट स्टेप क्या होंगे और डिमांड क्या है आपकी?
हमारे स्टेप्स हैं कि हम सारे नेशनल यूनाइटेड नेशन है, इंटरनेशनल कोर्ट ऑफ जस्टिस है, क्रिमिनल कोर्ट है, अपनी सुप्रीम कोर्ट है, अपना नेशनल ह्यूमन राइट्स, हम उनको फिर अप्रोच करेंगे, एक फिर उनको कहेंगे कि देखो भैया, अगर आप 30 साल के बाद 1984 राइट्स में अभी सज्जन कुमार को लाइफ इम्प्रिजनमेंट दे रहे हैं कि आप इतने देर के बाद आप कहोगे आप इतनी देर क्या कर रहे थे, 30 साल हम लड़ रहे हैं कोई सुन नहीं रहा, तो हम फिर चिल्लाना चाहते हैं हम टॉप ऑफ द वर्ल्ड भाई तो जागो, दुनिया में आजकल बार्बरिज्म बर्बरतिया हो रही है और यहाँ एक शरीफ कौम है उनको कोई सुनता नहीं, वो मर रहे हैं तो ठीक है अच्छा।
गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया से क्या डिमांड है?
दैट वी आर नॉट माइग्रेंट्स, हम इंटरनल रिफ्यूजीज हैं, हम अपनी खुशी से नहीं निकले हैं। ये जगमोहन थ्योरी जो है कॉन्स्पिरेसी थ्योरी, ये टोटली ब्लास्ट करनी है कि जगमोहन ने हमें निकाला। कोई मुझे कहेगा अपनी घर छोड़ो, मैं एक डॉक्टर था प्रोफेसर था पढ़ाता था मेडिकल कॉलेज में, ये सारा छोड़ के मैं घर छोड़ के प्रैक्टिस छोड़ के अपने भाई बंधुओं को छोड़ के दोस्तों को छोड़ के हम भाइयों को छोड़ के अपना मकान छोड़ के कोई जगमोहन के कहने पर मैं जाता और यहाँ टेंटू में रहता। ये मैं सोचता हूँ ये दुनिया में कहाँ ये अकल कहाँ है, कौन सोचता है, कौन लोग हैं जो इस कंस्पिरेसी को फैला रहे हैं और किस ढंग से फैला रहे हैं कि सारे जैसे जिसको कहते हैं फेक न्यूज़ गलेबल है सारी दुनिया, हाँ ये कह रहे हैं ठीक है, तो कोई ना कोई तो सुनना चाहिए क्योंकि हम छोटी कौम है, हमारी बात कोई सुनता नहीं, मगर हम कहते हैं हम छोटे हैं मगर हम बहुत चलाएंगे, हम बोलेंगे।
सर ये जेनोसाइड का ऑलमोस्ट 28 ईयर्स हो गया है, तो कुछ लेट नहीं हुआ ये चीज़ शुरू करने के लिए, या इससे पहले शुरू कर देना चाहिए था या 28-30 साल के बाद शुरू हुआ?
बोले कि 30 साल से हम कर नहीं, आपको तो पता है
जेनोसाइड का मतलब रिकॉग्निशन के लिए 90 से
जेनोसाइड वी हैव यूज्ड दिस वर्ड फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट, इफ यू लुक एट योर फर्स्ट रेजोल्यूशन एंड व्हिच वी सबमिटेड टू द इंटरनेशनल बॉडीज जेनोसाइड इज द फर्स्ट वर्ड बिकॉज़ जेनोसाइड मींस द इंटेंट टू मर्डर decimate and exculpate a country. Ethnic cleansing is to throw them out. Both things have happened in our case. It is ethnic cleansing, it is genocide and nothing short of
it. Aisa hai ke, as you already know that Kashmiri Pandits are original inhabitants of Kashmir. We have 5,000 years history there. We have been chased out from our hearths and homes, hounded out. And the second layer, after subjecting us to ethnic cleansing, religio-cultural cleansing, the second layer follows to erase all the symbols, signs that loudly speak about our existence for thousands of years. And you'll be surprised to know that Jammu and Kashmir government on the floor of assembly itself declared and announced in the year 2012 that as many as 218 temples were demolished, vandalized or razed to ground. I mean, we know that the figures given by them is on the figures given by them are on the lower side. They are even much more. Even government agencies have been found implicit in usurping and encroaching upon our even cremation grounds. So there's a bill pending in the state legislature, and we have been spearheading the movement right from 2011 for passage of temples and shrines bill, so that a statutory and legal protection was provided to all our temples, all our shrines. Some of them are as old as when two main religions of the world had not taken place, like Islam and like Christianity, like Shankaracharya temple. I mean, the government once tried to introduce a bill in state legislature to rename officially Shankaracharya as Takht Suleiman. I mean, government has been found as overground facilitators with land mafia in usurping our temples. So that is another thing, how glaringly we are being subjected to discrimination when there is already a provision for this, a legal provision for this Awqaf Trust. And for under Awqaf Trust and under this Gurdwara Prabandha Committee. So we want parity and we want discrimination to be ended. So as you said, our initiative, global Kashmiri Pandit Diaspora initiative, it's an initiative all Kashmiri Pandits are involved in. By their hearts, by their souls, we want that this genocide should be recognized. That's the first thing. It's not being recognized. Instead, insults are heaped on us. As Dr. Saab rightly said, somebody said that, say, Governor Jagmohan facilitated you and he wanted you to leave. He showed us some green postures. I mean, I personally have suffered to the tune of lakhs of rupees. So how could we leave our hearths and homes, dear hearths and homes, our homeland? So the thing is that we want, first of all, we should not be called migrants, we should be called internally displaced, and our genocide should be recognized, and causes of the exodus is there, they should be reversed. So, and we want, so this voice, through this voice, this is an organized voice of the whole community. So we want now even this voice to be heard at international levels. That's why global Kashmiri Pandit Diaspora is even approaching, besides Indian agencies, UNO bodies, those bodies who deal with human rights violations, because there cannot be any worse human rights violation than suffered by Kashmiri Pandits. And we are in perpetual suffrage. Thank you.